When did your interest in music begin?
So I was about quite kind of old for starting. I started about 11 years old. Used to play with my younger brother. Just we used to record things off the radio and things like that, and make up our own stupid like songs, like child songs. And then I started again. I had like a pair of knitting needles that I got from my mum, and was playing like an old Quality Street tin, like one of those really old big tins, you know, and you can get lots of different sounds out of them. I was playing around with that, and I remember just making a real noise with it, you know, a racket, and she burst into my room, you know, and I thought, that's it, she's going to tell me off, to tell me to stop. And she said, do you want drum lessons? And I was like, yes, I do, you know. And before that, I'd done a bit of tap dancing, ballet tap, jazz dancing. I liked the tap more. I kept pushing the teacher, can we learn something new? You know, can we do a different routine? And used to annoy everyone else by kind of, you know, wanting to do something new and wanting to move on a bit further and things. So that's, I think, the rhythmic element of it I really liked, and expressing it through your body.
Yeah.
I was lucky enough to have drum lessons at school from an ex-Marine who run a swing band, local swing band for young and young people at school, and also ex-Marines were in there as well. So there were like some really good trumpet players and things, you know, and really experienced, you know. And they used to, I got in there when I was 14. I remember sitting in the car park with my mum, who had brought me, you know, thinking I don't want to go in, you know, like it's going to be really hard, you know. It's all like body rich charts and stuff, and lots of reading, you know. Yeah. And he taught me to read, you know, and I got a lot of work from that, being able to read music, play shows, you know, anything like that. Well, not when I was still at school,
right,
as well. So I was working a lot in the evenings and doing the studying in the day as well, and out weekends doing little jazz things, and you know, it's great, all with people
that
were
playing.
Yeah, just local little jazz things, all with, like, you know, my teachers and people that are a lot older than me. So I was lucky to be around people and managed to learn a lot from them, and they gave me some really nice advice as well, you know. But in this swing band, I remember the trumpet section, about five people sitting right behind me, you know, and I'm on the drums, you know, I'm a little kind of 14-year-old girl. And saying, oh, you gotta swing harder, you know, you gotta make it swing, and you gotta get that hit there, and you know, in these charts, you know. And I really wanted to do it. They kind of annoyed me, but I thought, I want to get this right for them, you know, I want to make it. So I went back to the Buddy Rich videos, watching him, you know, see, I mean, you know, he's really driving the band, you know. And I like the fact as well that I was the only one on the drums, you know, the one instrument, like five trumpets, five saxes, you know, one drum kit, and I could, you know, really take it anywhere I wanted, you know, and they'd, they'd follow me if I was strong enough. And that, yeah, that band really was my first experience of jazz, big band jazz, you know. I did a little bit of small group, but when I went to college when I was 18, I auditioned for the London colleges of Leeds and things, and knew that I wanted to do something with drum kit, but not necessarily rock or pop. I loved rock music as well. My dad listened to a lot of rock music. My family aren't musicians. My mum likes Motown tunes and stuff. They really appreciate music, but they don't play an instrument themselves.
Which rock bands did he listen to?
AC/DC, Led Zeppelin, all the
traditional ones.
Classics, yeah, classics, exactly. My dad did have a drum kit before I was born, but he got rid of it before I was born. He used to take lessons on it to it's nice to have a hobby of something like that, you know, away from his work. He worked really hard, you know, in his job. He was a gardener, so he's out physically, you know, physical labour, getting really cold and working really hard. And, you know, so I know he had the drums, they were gone before I was born. So, you know, I think I definitely got something from him, you know.
But he never played in bands and things like that.
He never played in bands. He had a few lessons when he was younger, and used to just mess around at home, I think. But yeah.
Interesting. Do you have brothers and sisters, or?
So my brother, he doesn't play an instrument, but he's really, really musical. I always say to him, he could be a great drummer, you know, because he would just mess around at home, and you know, he'd come. He's left-handed like me, so it's easy for us to just switch on. You know, he can get on straight away. And we used to mess around, you know, with my friend, and you know, she'd play guitar and stuff, you know, we just have a little jam, and he's so musical, but he didn't go down the musical route, but he loves music, he goes to loads of gigs, you know, he likes rock and pop, things like that, so indie and things, he's really into music, and he's a great singer, he's got a great musical mind, you can tell, you know, when he's talking about music, so, but as for physically playing an instrument, it's just me and my family, yeah.
Right. What about, you've got a new record out, haven't you, that you did, a new CD.
Yes.
When did you start that? How did you begin?
So it really began kind of many years ago when Paul, Michael, the bass player, and I, we met at college when I was 8. We were both 18. And we started to play together a lot in lots of different things, big bands, small bands, functions, pop. We were in a rock band together, you know, so we did a lot of different things. And instantly I knew he was a great bass player and I wanted to work with him in the future. So we only recorded the album 2 years ago now. So it's been a long time coming. We've worked on a lot of the grooves. They've evolved a lot. I was listening to some old practice videos, you know, that I've got on my phone and stuff. And you can hear the grooves kind of in the first form and they've kind of traveled a long way. So, you know, going back to that, just kind of reviewing the tour and stuff, it's really nice to see how much it's grown in that time. So I'm glad that I haven't rushed it. But it has taken a long time for me to put out.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think it's you know, it's exactly how I wanted it to sound, and you know, the bass, like some of the bass melodies and stuff on there, and the compositions and the arrangements. We've worked for a long time on those, and you know, got together separately to go through the grooves and stuff like that. So yeah, and think about how the tune, we want the tunes to go and stuff. Because obviously their tune is written by other people.
All of them
who were involved with Ed Blackwell, the drummer, at some point in his career.
Yeah.
And we've gone for like more of a modern approach by putting these grooves in. Obviously he's electric bass, so that's given it another angle as well.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's been finally here, and it's called Eden. So yeah, we're really glad to launch it.
Mm. And how's it doing? It must be doing quite well. You've been on tour for a few weeks now.
Yeah, we've been on tour. So this is about our 15th date now out of 19 dates across the UK. And to be honest with you, I'm absolutely delighted and surprised that it's been reviewed so well. Four stars in The Guardian and a five-star review from BBC Music Magazine. So some amazing comments, and it just, you know, it's so unsure. It's my debut album as well. It's I was so just kind of, I knew I was happy with it, but when putting it out there, you know, it's almost like a real risk, basically. You know, you're really putting yourself out there. You know,
it is you out there. Yeah, it's a health risk.
Yeah. So to hear some of the comments I've had, you know, individual sound, you know, refreshing approach, total knockout. It's like it's great to hear, you know, and it really makes me want to do more. You know, it gives you that good kind of, you know, yeah, we want to hear more of you, and you know, you know, I'd had it a little bit, but I knew I wanted to get to the end of it, you
course,
know, and pursue it. But yeah, to hear the reviews coming for this album is really great.
After the tour, what's going to happen?
So I'm gonna. It's been really exhausting in every angle because I've been doing lots of the admin for it as well.
Yeah.
So I need to take a lot of time to reflect on all the feedback that we've had from the gigs, and there's already been a few bookings for like the same project in future events, possibly Love Supreme, some gigs at the Vortex, organised by Deirdre Cartwright. So that's really interesting. So yeah, things are coming in. It's going to be nice to have a break for it and then come back in like February, March, you know, and get the project out there again. And we're going to keep we have CDs available, so we're going to keep it going, you know, for at least another year or so. And you know, with the reviews I've got now, hopefully I can like apply for some festivals and stuff. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
And they actually kind of have a bit more of an idea who I am and what I sound like and what I do as well. So yeah, I'm going to have a bit of a break, but I'm going to keep pushing it as well, see if we can get in, you know, other stuff next year. As for future projects, obviously I want to continue to work with Paul because we have a lot more ideas to come, and I want him to be at the centre of, you know, my future projects as well. So yeah, I mean, it's going to be more stuff, definitely, because it's a little bit addictive, even though it is the hardest work I've ever done. But it's kind of like, oh, you know, they're kind of like that, you know, people are getting it, you know. And that makes me want to think about what's next, you know.